1993, Sega AM2, led by Yu Suzuki, unleashed Virtua Fighter 1 upon the arcade scene, the first 3D polygon fighting game. Unlike Virtua Fighter, it had more frames of animation to appear nearly fluid. Many of the moves were taken from motion-captured martial artists, giving a solid feel to the fighters. The jumps were floaty, but the impacts were brutal. Panoramic views gave the replays extra pizzazz, and AM2 had another hit. Next, Sega upgraded to the new Lockheed Martin chipset called the Model 2, and Virtua Fighter 2 was released on it the following year. And what an achievement it was! Texture map polygons and bilinear filtering were such a significant jump from its predecessor, some would say a sequel has never appeared so many leaps and bounds ahead of its predecessor again. Virtua Fighter 2 is sumptuous, and gorgeous, and twice the speed of its 30 frames per second predecessor. It has 3D backgrounds and the infamous Shun-Di bridge level. Subsequently, in 1996, Sega unveiled its Model 3 hardware with the release of Virtua Fighter 3, which also was drop-dead beautiful, but not nearly the step-up that Virtua Fighter 2 had been from Virtua Fighter 1. It added smoothing to the polygon's edges. Its levels had slopes. It added a dodge button that nobody liked and was removed from the subsequent iterations. It cost me $1 to play at the arcade I found it at, when 50 cents was the going rate for most 3D games. This game did not do as well as VF2 in America, but did incredible in Japan. I was a Virtua Fighter junkie with Virtua Fighter 1 and 2 for the Sega Saturn. The Saturn's VF2 had a mode in which the AI would learn from your playing the game, and at one point, I literally could not beat the AI from everything it had learned from me. I wore my Virtua Fighter 2 CD down to unplayability, and then the internet began to buzz with the promise of a Virtua Fighter RPG. It would star Akira and feature Virtua Fighter combat in an action game setting. With the home release of VF3 for the Dreamcast, we finally saw that this game had become Shenmue. It featured martial arts as promised, and many of the characters shared the same movesets as the Virtua Fighters, but it was a completely separate story with separate characters. Virtua Fighter was about a worldwide tournament started by an evil corporation, Judgment 6, who wanted to steal the moves of the contestants and program them into the robotic fighters. The prototype cyborg, Doral, was a memory-wiped version of the Kunoichi Tsukikage, Kage's mother. Jackie's sister, Sarah Bryant, was brainwashed to fight to summon Jackie so the Judgment 6 could learn her Jeet Kune Do style. Virtua Fighter was already a wuxia soap opera with a mixture of Chinese and Japanese elements. It was ready to be an RPG. While Shenmue started as such, it was not an explicit Virtua Fighter RPG. This was.
Without a hitch? Are you kidding? Give me a break! Do you know what I had to go through to get this?
Save it for later. You got back okay. That's all that matters, right?
This is the real Virtua Fighter action RPG. And no, it's not good. It's a shameless by-the-numbers action title for kids. It's sparse and anemic. Everything is there for practical use as dictated by the design document. It's padded with busy work. The story is one big trope fest and characters wouldn't stand out in a third-rate no-play. It's developed by Tosei, the infamous Roger Corman-esque ninjas of the video game world who developed crap like the Avatar Airbender game where you can get 1,000 Xbox Gamer Score on the first level. I can't find any love in this thing. Virtua Fighter deserved better. Let's see where everything went wrong.
So this is the inside of a forgotten server.
Okay, is it C or is it Say? Because this game contradicts itself a lot.
Do this, you know?
Don't get so excited, Hayami. This is my first time, remember?
Alright, as you can see here, this is your basic walking animation. And your basic turnaround animation. You can run in all cardinal directions by the Italian company. And here's our jump. It is not responsive in the least. There's a pause between hitting the button and watching the character jump. It is not good design. You also have this laser rope thing called a wire. It's used to latch yourself to enemies or grappling points, and nothing else. You also have a double jump. And you have a Prince of Persia wall run. And you have a crappy camera. Did I mention the crappy camera? The camera can't be adjusted. All you can do is press L1 or L2 to set it behind you, but aside from that, you can't move it. Also, you have this wall somersault. It's useless. And you can grab on the ledges, just like Tomb Raider. And do another wall run. Did I mention this game really likes wall runs? And you can knock things down.
See, I told you so. Security always comes when you hang around too long. That robot's probably a protector.
Hayami, Hayami, it's coming after me. What should I do?
You know that hunter's glove on your right hand? It isn't just for show. It's got martial arts programs installed on it. Press the circle button to attack. Give it a try!
Voice acting! Oh god. Oh god. This is the combat. You have a light punch and a strong punch. As well, you have all these moves. Charge, throw, floater, strike, dash, and jump. Every one of them is going to be replaced with a Virtual Fighter character's move. And you can attack in the air. Oh boy. And you use your wire in order to pull yourself towards an enemy. And as you can see here, the wire is very finicky. It really won't attach itself until you're just at the perfect angle. Classic game design here. Absolutely. No question. Now, Wall's doing wonderful things to the frame rate. Hey, remember when the Planet Money podcast went to the Porcupine Freedom Festival in New Hampshire? The annual libertarian convention where they use alternative currencies to sell each other food, booze, and drugs? They had bacon weave there. Succulent libertarian bacon weave. Anyway.
So, this is a data chip.
Sounds like you got it! Now get back here! Just log out and you'll be home free.
Nice work! Looks like you made it back without a hitch.
No.
Without a hitch. Are you kidding? Give me a break! Do you know what I had to go through to get this? Save it for later. You got back okay?
Right, we saw this before. Right?
Just let me see that data chip, okay? What? That's it? Hey, Hayami, look, don't blame me. This was my first shot at treasure hunting, remember? If you keep making excuses like that all the time, you're not gonna do any better at the air bike race in Acropolis either, say?
Come on, give me one more chance, Hayami. This time, I'll find a better data chip. Promise!
Well, I can't get your bike ready right away anyway, so I guess...
Happy birthday, Say. I'm sorry, but... work's been so busy that I can't come home again. To make it up to you, I've sent you a hunter's glove, like you've always wanted. Have fun in Nexus, son.
Oh yeah, I should probably explain what the Nexus is.
In the not-so-distant future, mankind has begun to live in places other than just the surface of the Earth. However, human desire knows no bounds. Not satisfied with the real world, people have taken to living their lives in virtual reality, created by computers. The virtual world of Nexus. Conveniently accessible from anywhere in the world via network. Nexus has become a part of everyday life. As time passed, unmanaged, neglected areas in the data servers appeared. However, people continue to live even here, in the forgotten corners of Nexus. And then, there are those who access these forgotten areas and search for lost data. These explorers have come to be known as treasure hunters.
A new hunter's glove? I've never seen this type
before. Oh god, this was
really?
Motion captured, wasn't it?
Isn't this one of those gloves that your dad makes?
Then it's an original? Hey, do you think it's any good?
Didn't you say that your dad was a Nexus engineer? Man, I wish I were good enough to make something like this. Given your last treasure hunting experience, I think it'd be better if you go to the hunter site and get a hunter's license first.
A hunter's
license? This is a Virtua Fighter game, right?
The Hunter's Guild's an organization created to help you,
right?
And fellow hunters out with things. They issue you a hunter's license when you become a guild member. It's sort of like an ID card. The guild can teach you all sorts of things, and other hunters get together there to share information about Nexus. You've got nothing to lose by joining.
Okay, let's check it out then.
Welcome to the hunter site. You must be a new hunter, am I right?
That's right.
And we don't care about anything she has to say. So, as you can see, we're now in Phantasy Star Online. You can see everybody has a mag. They come in different shapes. You can feed them and raise them as you want, change their stats, which changes their different abilities. How about that guy named Lister? How about him, huh? Somebody loved Red Dwarf. They even have that folded-in-half art style that they had in Phantasy Star Online. See? You remember Phantasy Star Online? Wasn't it great? Oh god, the hunter's test. Jumping. Just the camera doesn't help with jumping. You can't tell where your feet are going to be. You can't tell what way you'll be facing when you dismount a ledge. If you attack something in the air, you have to be one space away. No more, no less. Remember what Goya says here. They're going to contradict it.
It looks like you got your hunter's license.
I did, didn't I? So does this mean that I can log into servers and start collecting data chips now?
Yep. But first, you should get your hunter's rank up. If your hunter's rank is low, it'll be hard to get server information.
Rank? What do you mean?
Well, it's sort of like a scale of how good you are. You increase your rank by taking more advanced tests. Right now, you've got the lowest rank, low A. The next highest rank is high A. I'm one rank higher than that, XA.
Wow, you must be pretty good then, Hayami.
I better watch out or I'll get a swelled head. Well, I'm gonna head back and start working on the air bike. So start earning some money.
God, it's the same level we had before.
Greetings. Welcome to the virtual world of Nexus.
Dramatic pause.
Who are you?
I'm Bit, and I'll be your navigator. Nice to meet you. I'm here to help out treasure hunters like you.
Oh, is that your function? Well, I'm Say. Nice to meet you.
You too. Now, let's go start looking for data chips.
Data chips? Easy. There, we just found one. Can we go now?
numbers of protectors detected. Switch to battle mode?
Battle mode? I'm not sure I know what that means, but if it'll help, then yes.
That is definitely the voice of a teenager, isn't it? Make sure you beat up all the UFOs in front of the Italian company. And sugar, sugar. Sugar, sugar. I love spending my weekends down at the old sugar, sugar, don't you? Yeah, you can't get by this. And we have a repair program. Can we go now? Oh boy. I wonder where it is. There we are.
A dead end?
Leave this world at once. That is, if you wish to remain yourself.
What? Who are you?
It's too dangerous for you to stay here any longer. Leave now.
All right, I'll leave. Bit, log out.
Log out unsuccessful. Command unavailable.
What?
He's being invaded in Dark
That's
Souls.
Impossible.
Nah,
Try
just
again.
Kidding. This is a flagrant ripoff of Dot Hack.
Hey, what am I? Hayami! Hey, Hayami! Hayami!
It seems that they've managed to find you.
They? They who?
You're better off not knowing.
Yes, because preserving a mystery is always more important than understanding the stakes.
What's more important is that you remember what I say next. On the other side of this building, there's a warehouse. Someone is waiting for you there.
Waiting for me? Who could
Spoilers!
Possibly...
Are you the one who seeks power? Why do you seek power?
Because I want to forge my own path?
In order to test my martial art abilities, I entered a world fighting championship.
Go!
However, it turned out to be nothing more than a trap. A trap set to gather data from fighters all around the world. They took this data that they collected from us and used it to make weapons. Humanoid fighting machines, Durals.
Durals?
The time has come where you must stand against this threat. My name is Akira Yuki. I am the one who seeks such strength. Allow me to test your determination. Very well. Now I shall teach you the true strength of Hakyoku Ken. Ha! 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 This is Moko Kohazan. Your fist shall be the power that allows you to forge your own path.
But we don't have Akira's power yet, so the fighting's still really boring.
If you want to log out of this server, you'll need to defeat the root user. Get the power, and then head for that building.
That building? With that man? Huh? On the day the snow turned to rain? So, these are the Durals.
Are these the guys she warned me about?
Now, about the combo system in this game. It's terrible. And even worse, it doesn't follow Virtua Fighter's standard for combos. 1, 2, 3. Now, the standard combo in Virtua Fighter is punch, 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 kick. But the standard combo in Virtua Quest is punch, pause, punch, pause, punch. Oh, and if you do a strong punch, forget it. You can't combo it. At all. Combat stinks now.
It seems that you're indeed worthy of this power.
Who are you?
My name is Raud. Will you take this power to fight them?
Them? You mean those guys that are after me?
Yes. They are planning to use Nexus to plunge the world into chaos. If you have the will to fight them, then the power shall be yours. If somebody doesn't fight them, their plan will succeed. And then, people are going to suffer. Of course, I believe that this power is also your only way to escape.
Hey, that's not fair!
The choice is yours.
What choice?
Fine, I'll take it. I don't know what I can do, though.
Take this disc and hold it up. The tools inside will install themselves, and you will be able to use Synapse Break.
Matrix mode.
All right, I'll do my best.
There's one more thing I must tell you. They're searching Nexus for special data clusters. Virtua Souls.
Virtua Souls?
With Virtua Souls, even the toughest security can be defeated.
So once you have a Virtua Soul, you can equip it.
The Virtua Souls lie unawakened here in this world. Nexus. Surely you can feel their presence.
What is it, Bit?
There is a Virtua Soul nearby. I'm sure of it.
You really think so, huh?
Of course. The Virtua Soul detector is working perfectly.
After this, Say gets another power. It's useful, except it can kill you. Uses a chunk of your health, but it clears off everything on the screen. And then we get a boss.
So, you've made it this far, have you now?
You're the one who's preventing us from leaving, aren't you?
Knowing that won't do you any good now, boy.
Any good?
After I beat you down, I'll make you my prisoner. It's too bad, really. If he were here, you'd make a nice gift for him. But he's not here. And I'm sick of looking at you. It's over for you now.
So then we have to fight him. Wait, where did he get that move? Oh, right.
Ah, do you have a pursuing spirit to go against the true nature of things?
Pursuing spirit?
All things have both a front and a back. You mustn't allow yourself to see things merely on the surface. You must act so that you are able to find the truth in all things. I am Shun Di. I wish to see your determination. You are still young. Do not forget the pursuit for truth as you progress through life.
And we beat him.
You've got a Virtua Soul?
Is this the power of a Virtua Soul?
Don't get any funny ideas. That power isn't yours. You're gonna have to give it back.
This power? What are you talking about?
Find out for yourself.
What?
Logout block removed. Logout commencing.
Oh, great. Thanks. Oh, God. That was Virtual Quest.
It continues to be Virtual Quest. It continues to haunt me in my dreams that this is what we got. This is the Virtual Fighter RPG that Sega thought we deserved. I'm gonna have to start drinking. Please, somebody in the comments recommend me something good and strong. Thank you.
Was that acceptable?
Yes. There's no need to worry about him. Besides, you've done your part.
This must end soon.